Hi, I'm Ayotunde Balogun, and here's your Channel's TV Evening News Recap for October the 31st, 2019. The police have rescued 12 victims from an illegal spiritual healing center at the Sheri Osho area of Jegun in Lagos State. The center, called Blessings of Goodness Healing Church, is set to harbor about 20 victims, some of whom have been in chains since 2014. According to police spokesman Mr. Bala Elkana, the chained victims are barely able to walk and had to be removed first before law enforcement personnel evacuated the rest. Staying with security matters, the Kaduna State Government has vowed to facilitate the establishment of a military formation in the Gabi local government area of the state. This vow comes on the heels of recent cases of kidnappings, rural banditry and other related crimes in the Rigasa and Naria communities in the Gabi. In a bid to tackle such prevailing security challenges, Governor Nasser El-Rufai announced plans by the state government to engage in activities that will lead to the establishment of a military formation in the area. To diplomatic matters, Nigeria and Vietnam have signed an agreement on waiver of visa requirements for holders of valid diplomatic and official passports in both countries. The Vice President, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, and the Deputy Prime Minister of the Socialist Republic of Vietnam, Mr. Vuong Dinh Hue, witnessed the signing and exchange of memorandum of understanding during a meeting on Wednesday at the presidential villa in Abuja. Minister of State for Foreign Affairs, Ambassador Zubairu Dada, signed on behalf of Nigeria, while his counterpart, the Vietnamese Vice Minister of Foreign Affairs, Mr. Nguyen Minh Vu, signed on behalf of his government. On the international scene, at least 74 people were killed and dozens injured after cooking gas cylinders exploded on a train packed with pilgrims in Pakistan on Thursday, with some dying after leaping from carriages to escape the inferno. Television footage showed flames pouring out on three carriages as people could be heard crying during the incident in a rural area of central Punjab province. And in sports, Novak Djokovic saw Britain's Kyle Edmund on Thursday to reach his eighth Paris Masters quarterfinal, while Grigor Dimitrov knocked out fifth seed Dominic Thiem. Top seed Djokovic battling Rafa Nadal for the year-end world number one spot needed 7 points in the first set before winning 7-6, 6-1. And that's the evening news recap. Join us later for fresh updates. I'm Ayotunde Balogun. Many thanks for watching.